So my name is Alicia Zhou. I'm a postdoctoral fellow in this lab. I'm in the lab of Dr. Andrei Goga at UCSF Medical Center. So I work on breast cancer research, and in particular, I'm looking at micro-RNAs and how they play a role in breast cancer. And the hope is to find a novel treatment for breast cancer by studying these micro-RNAs and finding ways to inhibit them. So I was born in China, in Beijing, China, and I came to the U.S. when I was 5, and I've grown up in the U.S. ever since. And I became really interested in biology when I was in probably middle school, high school, and I realized that I really enjoyed science, all science, sort of chemistry, physics, and biology. But biology to me was the most intriguing one because I found it to be really interesting to study the way that life happens, especially human life. And I talked to my high school teacher, and she was my AP biology teacher, and I told her that I wanted to try my hand at biology, and she was really nice, and she introduced me to some professors. So I ended up contacting a bunch of different professors at the university, and one of them got back to me, and his name was Dr. Jeff Green. He was a breast cancer researcher at the University of Chicago Medical Center, and he was really happy to take me on. So then the summer of my junior year, I kind of just walked into his lab, and he gave me a project and a mentor, and I just started working at the bench. So a micro-RNA is a really small piece of RNA. So RNA is one of the basic building blocks of life, and it's usually used to encode for proteins in the human body, but it's actually been found that there are these really small strands of micro-RNAs, and instead of coding for proteins, what they actually do is they can bind to other pieces of RNA and inhibit them by locking them up and keeping them from becoming protein. And so then if we can inhibit the micro-RNAs, then we can alleviate their inhibition of RNAs, and that can help to change the cell. And depending on what disease you're studying, so in my case in breast cancer, sometimes micro-RNAs can be inhibiting things that we need to be not inhibited. So if we can stop the micro-RNAs from functioning, then we can sort of fix the cancer cell. So my day basically consists of doing a lot of experimental bench work, which means that I set up a lot of experiments that are using, I use human cancer cell lines. So that means that I go into the tissue culture hood and use sterile technique, and I work with these human cancer cell lines. These are cell lines that came from actual patients. And then I also do a lot of biochemistry on the bench. So sometimes I'll be at my bench doing sort of what we call in vitro work, which is where we isolate different components of the cells and put them together or take pieces apart to sort of figure out what's going on. The thing about biology is that it doesn't always work. In fact, it almost always doesn't work. But you kind of have to have a resilience about it, and you have to be really curious about what kind of science you're doing. One of the obstacles is overcoming the fear of failure, because I think that happens a lot in science. Often you make a hypothesis and you think it's going to work out one way and it doesn't at all. And then you think that means that you were wrong and that you failed, but really you have to just come at your question with a different angle, and oftentimes you can work through that, and then it's actually really rewarding at the end when you have overcome your own failures and you're able to get the results that you want, and also you sometimes discover something that's completely different or opposite from what you originally thought was going to happen, and actually that's actually really cool. Science is a great equalizer. You don't need to have anything to do science other than a really curious mind. And science is one of those things, it doesn't matter where you came from or how much money you have or you know who your parents are. In the end, science doesn't care about that. It's just about, can you be curious? Can you ask interesting questions? Are you willing to think about big ideas and be brave enough to follow those ideas? And so I would say that you should never be afraid to do science because it's very, very rewarding. And like I said, there are no wrong answers in science. They're only interesting answers in science. So even if you get a negative result that isn't what you expected, it doesn't mean that you failed. It just means that you may have come upon something that you didn't expect. And so I think science is just, it really is the great equalizer. It doesn't matter where you come from or what you do. Anybody can do science.